This morning in the Rhode Show Kitchen, we are joined by Chef Ray Montaquila. He is here from the Coast Guard House. He's to my left, your right. Good morning, Ray.
Morning.
Nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
Thank you so much for being here with us today, and I'm very excited. As the audience can see now watching, this is going to be really something. Today we're making savory bread pudding. Is this one of your favorite things to make? Is it up there?
It's definitely up there.
Yeah.
It's something different. You know, a lot of people think of bread pudding as something that has to be sweet, but it can be savory and delicious as well. I mean, you know.
Tremendous. I can't take my eyes off the bread. So take us through some of the ingredients that we'll be working with here today, if you could.
Okay. Well, obviously we have some really nice bread.
Mm-hmm. A key component to savory bread pudding.
Indeed. So we have some sweet bread, and we have some, you know, some rustic Italian bread, some French baguette. And you can really use any bread you want, but we'll get into that later. We have some really nice mushrooms, certain variety, some cream, some eggs, some shallots, a little bit of salt, some butter, and that's really all there is to it.
Yeah, when I rounded the corner and came into the kitchen for the first time, I was blown away by everything here. But you were telling me it's really very rudimentary, it's basic. People should not be intimidated to maybe try this at home.
Not at all. It's almost foolproof.
Almost foolproof. Almost. So that means, Chef Ray, that even a guy like me might be able to tackle this?
Well, I think you'd be all right.
Yeah. He didn't sound too convincing, but we'll follow his lead. This is Chef Ray Montaquila. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
He is, of course, from the Coast Guard House. We will watch him prepare this all morning. We will learn more all about that fine establishment as the morning rolls on. For now, back over to you.
All right, we are back in the kitchen with Chef Ray, and actually owner Bob has joined us from Coast Guard House. Ray's busy cutting up some mushrooms, yes?
Yes,
I getting am. That bread pudding going. It's a savory bread pudding. If you haven't been to the Coast Guard House, it's a beautiful spot, but Bob really kind of suffers sometimes depending on the weather. A couple of years ago, we got hit hard, Superstorm Sandy. What actually happened to the Coast Guard House then?
Well, the first floor got cleaned out. The storm came in, obviously, in the evening and just wiped out the entire first floor. Lounge bar, kitchen, completely destroyed.
Really devastating stuff. But you are lucky enough that, you know, you have the funds, able to build it back up and do some beautiful renovations, which we have some pictures of.
Thanks.
So tell us about what you did.
Thank you. Yeah, it gave us the opportunity to reinvent the Coast Guard House. It's been a restaurant for 70 years.
Mm-hmm.
So we moved the kitchen and the lounge. The kitchen is now in the old building, very well protected with the old granite. And mm-hmm. the bar and lounge area now have a spectacular view of the water and Narragansett Beach.
Look at those photos that we're seeing right now. The bar's so open and beautiful, and you really can't beat that view, especially sitting on one of those chairs on the outside there.
You're exactly right. The Adirondack chairs are very popular.
And Coast Guard House, great for really any time of year. I know a lot of people associate it with the summertime, but I'm sure you have lots going on around this time of year.
We do. We're open year-round, and it's a nice time of year to come down. It's a little less quiet. It's a little quieter, I should say. And you can still enjoy the spectacular view.
Yeah, you make a good point. If you want to avoid those crowds, now is the perfect time. And also a time that you can enjoy some great food, which we are working on right now. We've got the mushroom slice, a couple different varieties there.
We do. We have four different varieties of mushrooms for this recipe. You know, you can use whatever kind of mushrooms you'd like. And we're just starting our custard here, which is going to be, you know, one of the binding ingredients and flavoring agents of the bread pudding itself.
So what is in the custard? What have you done? What have you
right now, I just have a little bit of cream and milk. I'm slowly heating it. I'm going to add a little bit of thyme to it, and it's just going to be a nice thyme custard, not necessarily mushroom custard.
Nice.
So
is this a special on the menu? Is it something that you like to incorporate?
It's actually something that we do for Thanksgiving at the restaurant. We've been doing it for years. Yeah, so, you know, figure it's that time of year and wanted to do something that's a side that people can make, something a little different for Thanksgiving itself.
And something delicious too, right, Bob?
That's exactly right.
Do you do holiday parties or events that people can take advantage of?
We do all types of holiday parties and functions and rehearsal dinners.
Perfect. So jump on it now. If you're looking to spend your holiday over at Coast Guard House, you can do just that. Savory bread pudding is what we're making. We're going to finish it up when we come back.
We are in the Rhode Show Kitchen. Chef Ray is here from Coast Guard House. We've got a savory bread pudding on the menu. It's one of those places that if you live in Rhode Island, grew up in Rhode Island, you've probably been to the Coast Guard House. Today, we got them right here. What do you want to do right now?
All right. Like I said earlier, we're making a savory bread pudding, as a opposed to what some you know, some people might think of as a typically a dessert.
Right.
Right.
Want to let everyone know that, you know, you can do anything. Right now we're doing mushrooms.
Okay.
You know, we wanted to do something that was a little bit different for Thanksgiving, let's say.
Sure.
Given the time of year. So just want to give people an idea of something very easy. It might seem intimidating, but
it's pretty simple to do. Yeah.
It's pretty foolproof.
Pretty foolproof.
You were eating custard earlier. You already sliced up all the mushrooms.
Did. We sliced up some mushrooms. Okay. So we've got a saute pan here. Just, you know, kind of low heat, medium low heat. Sorry. Gonna just kind of melt the butter a little bit. Thank you. And put some of these mushrooms in. Right now we have a blend of, we have some lobster mushrooms, we have some king oyster mushrooms, some shiitake, some black trumpets. You can really use whatever you like.
And a really bunch of different flavors, different, you know, and kind of blend together.
Sure.
Okay.
I like to steer people away from, you know, just solely using, let's say, a button mushroom or a portobello. I mean those are great mushrooms too, but every mushroom has a unique flavor and texture. And,
it certainly does.
You know, so you can branch out.
They're delicious too.
Absolutely. So if we're going to get that cooking, I'm going to turn the heat up a little bit.
Right. Now let's talk about the bread, because one of the bread was one of the first things that we saw. You really want a good bread when you when you make something like
of
this
course.
Too. And you've got it. So what do we have right here?
So here we have just a couple of French baguettes. We have some nice Sicilian bread, some French Italian bread, some brioche. I like to use a mix of bread. You can really use whatever you want. I suggest using something that. This is a little bit sweeter, a little bit softer, and this is something that is has a little more crust to it.
Okay.
Typically, bread pudding is made with something that's stale, because you
want... Right, yeah, that's true. It's a way to kind of revive that stale bread.
Yeah, you want the, you basically want the bread itself to, you know, retain its integrity and
hold
its
structure. Hold together, so you don't want something that's going to go to mush.
Exactly.
Right.
Right.
Yeah, I mean, you could always toast it if you don't have stale bread lying around. But,
right.
All right, so we're going to start cooking the mushrooms. While these are cooking, maybe... Kaylee can give that a stir periodically.
Okay, what do we need to do over here?
All right, so here we're going to make the base for the bread pudding itself. It's a custard base. A custard is essentially just, you know, a mixture of eggs and cream. Ice cream is a custard. Creme brulee is a custard.
Right.
Pudding in general is a custard. So right now, Will, if you wouldn't mind, we have some egg yolks here.
Okay.
We're going to put the egg yolks into the bowl.
Got those in.
All right.
Should we get everything? Okay.
And we're going to put the, we have some whole eggs as well.
Okay.
I like to use the egg yolks. It gives a little more richness as well.
So crack a couple of these right here?
Yeah, we can put those right in. I cracked those earlier.
I got nervous. I thought you were going
to
dump the whole
egg. No.
If you want to give it a try, that's fine. All right, so we're going
to start to whisk?
Yes.
Okay.
All right, I see you've done this before.
So that's good. A couple of times.
All right. All right, that's looking good.
Let me just put this last one there. All right, break that apart. Okay.
So we've also added a little bit of sugar to the custard mixture. Not because we want it to be sweet like a dessert, but just it kind of brings out the flavor of the thyme. I should also mention that too. We put a little thyme in here as well.
Okay.
The herb thyme.
Got it.
It was awesome.
So as you're pouring that in, should I be whisking this?
You should be, yeah. So we're going to do something, a process called tempering right now. It's just basically a way to heat the yolks without scrambling them.
Right.
Just go slowly on this.
Yep.
Oh,
keep them moving.
That's all right. Keep it going.
Okay.
All right, that's looking good.
Good. Okay.
So there we go. Now we have our custard base. We have our mushrooms going right here. We
they're really kind of rocking.
Give them a little season.
Down there. Perfect.
Some salt. All right. So over here in the front we have the bread. So let's take that. Thank you, Kayla.
You're welcome.
All right, so what we're going to do is... those mushrooms are looking good.
They look good. They smell good.
Perfect.
They are good.
There you go.
Thank you very much.
So, our team here.
That's good. Yeah, come to the kitchen anytime you want.
If you ever need us down there at the Coast Guard, how could you just ring us up?
I might take you up on it. All right, so right now we're going to just kind of mix in the mushrooms a little bit with the bread itself.
Okay. So they're all kind of blended around?
Excuse me. Yes. So
combine everything in that pan there.
Exactly. So we're just going to take the mushroom and bread mixture, put it into this baking dish. You can use anything you want.
Custard.
Sometimes it's better to use a deeper dish, you know, because you get that those different layers of texture. And,
right.
One of the most important parts, you know, I say it's foolproof. It pretty much is, because, you know, even if your custard isn't perfect or anything like that, it's bread. So the bread is going to... soak up and soak give it, it give it a lot more structure right. if you're trying to make a creme brulee or mm-hmm. a pudding or something like that. So
we're about to wrap up, Chef. So for the sake of time,
take this out.
Time and
there
temp when we are putting this in the oven.
Given you know the thickness of it, let's say about 35 minutes, about 325. I typically like to cook it in a water bath. It kind of evens out the cooking, so you don't have to, though.
Looks good to me.
It looks delicious. All right, and we will show you the finished product to close out the show. But if you want this recipe, looks delicious, it smells delicious, head on over to roadshow.com. Mm-hmm.